The US Navy's futuristic DDG X, Next Generation Destroyer. While largely conceptual at the moment, the Navy's DDG X program has already made considerable progress with requirements, conceptual work and computer simulation such that some initial renderings and technology integration schemes are taking shape. Most recently, the Navy has brought two prominent shipbuilders into the process, Huntington Ingalls Industries and General Dynamics. These shipbuilders, both of which have in recent years built destroyers, will contribute to the ongoing design work. They were brought in to support a Navy-led design team, according to comments made by Chief of Naval Operations Admiral Michael Gilday cited in USNI. DDGX Destroyer Warship Program. You've got high-powered lasers to incinerate enemy drones, more deck-launched interceptor cells, larger, longer-range and more lethal missiles and a breakthrough on-board power storage and distribution system, the Deputy Program Manager for the DDGX Program Office told an audience earlier this year at the 2022 Surface Navy Association Symposium. Much progress on the ship has already been made, as the Chief of Naval Operations has approved an initial set of potential requirements and the service has drafted a Preliminary Capabilities Development Document, CDD, for the ship. The ship will be architected to accommodate new technologies, weapons and sensors as they emerge, in part through the addition of an electrical propulsion and energy generation technology called the Integrated Power System. Destroyer Payload Module. We are designing this ship with the capability to in the future be increased in size with that block. So you would cut the ship and slide the block and to increase the size of the ship and allow for additional capability in the future, Connolly said. The initial focus, Connolly explained, will be on exploring a potential hull form or configuration, while moving to integrate, yet upgrade and advance many of the promising technologies now being built into the DDG 51 Flight 3 destroyers. We're going to use the Flight 3 combat system elements with the new hull form, which will have increased swap, size, weight and power, so you can accommodate different, larger and more power-dense systems, Connolly said. The plan is for the new DDG-X to operate alongside the Navy's growing fleet of DDG-51 Flight 3 destroyers, while also introducing and sustaining new concepts of operation, new breakthrough technologies, larger, stronger and more long-range weapons and a new generation of computing and command and control. The entire emphasis, Connolly explained, is to ensure the new warship can keep pace with new threats. Navy weapons developers and engineers are, as evidenced by the IPS system identified by Connolly, focusing heavily upon power and energy storage and distribution. An early rendering of the ship shows plans for two 600 kW lasers, a 150 kW laser on the front, 32 MK-41 vertical launch system cells and 12 larger missile cells for increased firepower. Supporting these kinds of new, high-powered weapons systems will require new applications for power and energy management, one reason perhaps why the Navy's graphic shows a place for an emerging Northrop Grumman system called IPS, Integrated Power and Energy System. Many of the promising technologies being woven into DDG 51 Flight 3, however, are going to be integrated as a baseline or starting point from which the DDG-X can evolve into a new generation of warship. The conceptual work on a future DDG-X destroyer is aimed at designing a new unprecedented warship to destroy enemies at sea well into the 2050s and beyond. Thank you for watching. Please like, share, comment, and subscribe.